Hello students, this class is for class 8 and we are discussing about the chapter element compounds and mixture. So for the separation techniques of liquid-liquid mixer, we have discussed two points, that is the fractional distillation and by separating funnel. So the third process, we are starting from chromatography, the separation type. So separation type. Conditions and examples. So the third separation type is chromatography. In chromatography, the conditions are when the components have similar properties. When the components have similar properties, they are difficult to separate out, and we apply the chromatography technique. So in the chromatography technique, we can give example about paper chromatography. This is one part of chromatography. There are various types of chromatography. So in this chromatography, the one part is paper chromatography. So in this paper chromatography, a plate is taken where the spot of the mixer is given here. Spot. Here is the spot of mixer. Mixer for liquids. And this is a chamber for solvent. Here some solvent is taken. Some solvent is taken. And when we dip that paper in that solvent, the spot moves like this. The spot moves in this, in the above portion. And after moving, the mixers are separated. Suppose it contains two mixers. It contains two liquids in this mixer. So we are getting two spots here like this. When we are giving a spot of mixer and we are putting that paper in a solvent chamber, the spot is moving upwards. And when it is moving upwards, it is separating the mixer like this. One spot is, we are getting one spot here and another spot here. That is, that means it represents that this spot contains two liquids, and that for two liquids, one liquid is giving one spot here and the second liquid is giving second spot here like this. So the more soluble substance rises faster. So between these two liquids, the liquid that is more soluble in this solvent gives this first spot, and the liquid that is less soluble gives this second spot, this spot. Okay, so we can write when components have similar properties. In conditions, we can write when components have similar properties. So when components have similar properties, you know, properties similar means they are difficult to separate. So we are applying this chromatography technique where the there is a difference in solubility, and the liquid that is more soluble in a particular solvent gives this first spot, this spot, and the liquid that is less soluble gives this below spot. Okay, the first spot, that above portion spot, is for liquid that is more soluble, and that is less soluble gives this lower spot. Okay, that is the separation technique. So for example, we can give here, that is components of ink. Components. Components of ink. So ink contains different constituents, different dye. Okay, ink contains different dye. So we can write ink contains different dye. And when ink contains different dye, when we apply this technique, we can separate the dyes by getting different spots. We can get different spots for different dye that is present in the ink, and we can separate them like this. Okay. So this paper is known as stationary phase. This paper is known as stationary phase. as it is fixed, no? It is fixed. And what is moving here? The solvent. The solvent is moving upwards, and with the solvent, the liquids are also moving. The liquid mixture is also moving upward with the solvent. So what is actually moving here? The solvent. So solvent is here, mobile phase. It is mobile phase. And the paper is stationary phase. It is fixed. And it is this, where the solvent is taken, is known as solvent chamber. So we are next, we are going to the point of advantage of chromatography. What are the advantages of chromatography? So for when we are saying about advantage of chromatography, that is very small quantity of substances can be separated. So advantage of chromatography, small quantity of substance can be separated. Substance can be separated. The next one we can say, that is, even after having similar chemical and physical properties, we can separate. That is the condition. When the components have similar properties, we can also separate them by applying chromatography. So that is the advantage of chromatography. Now, even after having similar chemical and physical properties, we can separate the components by applying chromatography. And it also helps in quantitative estimation. Helps in quantitative estimation. Quantitative estimation. And the third point is, even after having similar chemical and physical properties, similar physical and chemical properties, we can separate the components. So 3 points: small quantity of, very small quantity of substance can be separated, helps in quantitative estimation. Quantitative means we can determine the amount of a substance, we can determine the percentage purity, etc. Percentage yield, percentage purity, amount of substance, that is quantitative estimation. And even after having similar physical and chemical properties, we can separate the components. Physical properties mean boiling point, melting point, solubility, etc. And chemical properties mean the tendency of undergoing in any reaction. So when these are similar, there is very, we can find it difficult to separate that type of mixtures. And in that case, we can apply the chromatography technique. So next, what is the application of chromatography? What is the application of chromatography? Application. So, to separate drugs from the blood, to separate drugs from the blood and colors in a dye. Colors in a dye means, you know, I have said that is, we can separate the components of ink, and the components of ink are actually mixture of dye. So we can make it applicable for colors in a drug. To separate drugs from blood, one is drugs from blood, second is colors from a dye. Colors from a dye and to purify industrial products. As I have said, it can be used in quantitative estimation, and we can identify the percentage purity, percentage impurity, etc. So to purify industrial properties. To purify industrial properties or industrial products, you can say. So the next is the separation of liquid gas mixture. Separation of liquid gas mixture. So separation type conditions and examples. So first separation type is by boiling. So by boiling, we can separate the water and carbon dioxide. First, I am giving the example, then you can understand it in better. Water plus CO2, that is carbon dioxide gas. So when you are heating a liquid and a gas, that means the carbon dioxide gas is soluble in water, and the gas that is dissolved in a liquid comes out from that solution. The gas that is soluble in the liquid comes out from that solution when we are heating it. So what is the technique here? Actually, there is a condition where it says that upon heating, the solubility of a gas decreases. Upon heating, the solubility of a gas decreases, and that technique is actually applied here when we are boiling something. That means the gases that are dissolved in that liquid are coming out. Okay, and that is the condition. So based on the principle that the conditions are based on the principles that solubility of a gas decreases with increasing temperature. Solubility of a gas decreases with increasing temperature. This is a property. So whenever heating something, all the gases that are dissolved in that liquid will come out. Next is, this is the separation type of gas liquid mixture, and next is the separation of gas-gas mixture. Gas versus gas mixture. So the first separation type is diffusion. Diffusion of gases. This is also a technique, and it is a property of gases that gases can undergo diffusion. And this is a property for gases, and this technique is applied for the separation of gas-gas mixture. So diffusion. So this diffusion is applied when the gases have different densities here. Gases have different densities. For solid liquid mixture, difference in density gives centrifugation. And for liquid liquid mixture, the difference in density gives the separating funnel technique. And for gas gas mixture, the difference in density gives this diffusion technique. So, mixture of gases, we can say mixture of gases having different densities so the gas that have lower density, the gas that has lower density diffuses first. Lower density means lighter one. The gas that has lower density is lighter, and the lighter gas diffuses first. So we can say lighter gas diffuses more rapidly lighter gas diffuses more rapidly. So for example, we can give mixture of hydrogen and oxygen. Mixture of hydrogen and oxygen. So which one is lighter? You know that hydrogen is lighter than oxygen. Hydrogen is lighter than oxygen. So when we are trying to separate this hydrogen and oxygen by diffusion method, the hydrogen diffuses first and it separates from the mixture of hydrogen and oxygen. When we are applying diffusion method for hydrogen and oxygen, hydrogen diffuses first. When it diffuses first, it undergoes separation from oxygen. So the next is solvent extraction. Solvent extraction technique is applied when in the mixture of two gases, one gas is soluble in a particular solvent. So solvent extraction. So I'm giving example of carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide. Carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide. This is carbon dioxide and this is carbon monoxide. So when we are putting this mixture in water, we are taking a solvent water and putting this in that mixture, and carbon dioxide is soluble in water. This is soluble in water, right? But carbon dioxide is not soluble in water. So when we are putting that mixture over water, carbon dioxide becomes soluble in water, but carbon monoxide is not soluble. So we are separating these two mixtures. So in the solution phase, we are getting the carbon dioxide with water and carbon monoxide remains separated in the gaseous state. So carbon dioxide goes in the solution state with water and carbon monoxide remains in the gaseous state as it is not soluble in water. So that is the solvent extraction method. So when, what is the condition? When one gas is soluble in a particular solvent, but the other gas is not. So when one gas is soluble, like carbon dioxide is soluble in a particular solvent like water, but the other gas, that is carbon monoxide, is not soluble. And the last method is liquefaction. So gases can undergo liquefaction process. We can liquefy the gases by applying high pressure. So that technique is applied here. So last is liquefaction. So you are separating like ammonia and nitrogen. Ammonia and N2 nitrogen mixture. So between these two gas, in the application of pressure, when we are applying pressure, ammonia gas easily liquefied. There are many gases that can be easily liquefied, but not all the gases can be easily liquefied. So ammonia is easier to liquefy, but nitrogen is not. Upon application of pressure, ammonia easily liquefied, but nitrogen is not. So we are taking the conditions are what? Mixture of gases where one gas is easily liquefied, but the other is not. So when we are applying pressure and trying to liquefy a gas, one gas is liquefied, but the other gas is not. Other gas remains in the gaseous state. So this is the technique. So one gas is easily liquefied when one gas is easily liquefied at high pressure but the other gas does not. So in a mixture of ammonia and nitrogen, upon application of high pressure, ammonia liquefied, easily liquefied, but nitrogen don't. Nitrogen does not liquefy, and thus we can separate these two mixture, one in the liquid state and other in the gaseous state. So up to this, your chapter for elements, compound and mixture is completed. Okay.